Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to this YouTube channel. It's your guy Igor here. Today's video is dedicated to top 5 things your real estate agent doesn't want you to know. And being a real estate agent, you see, I'm in the middle of nowhere in a cornfield here. Well guys, I've been just driving to, well, I'm helping buy a house to someone in Strathmore. So I'm out of town and I want to tell you something that no other real estate agent, except, you know, crazy ones like myself, wants you to know, because it makes our life more difficult, more job to do, and these things are, well, here you go guys. First thing is, well, your real estate agent doesn't want you to know that besides buying a property, besides buying a house, you can ask for more. You can have a dining table, you can have a chair, you can even ask for some repairs, you can even ask for them to pay your condo fees in advance. 3 months, 6 months, don't worry, it's not COVID, or even 1 year. So you can ask for way more things when you're buying a property than real estate agents tell you. Why they don't tell you that? Well, it's more work, more negotiation, and to protect realtors, to protect my own self here, I want to tell you guys, when you start putting too much of nonsense, like that rusty old junk inside a house, inside the real estate transaction, there is less room for me to negotiate something for you. So there is less room to lower down the price for actually what matters, the real estate. So some people just put way far too much of things and they forget what they came there for. They didn't come there for an IKEA furniture shopping. They came there to buy real estate. And that's why real estate agents don't like mentioning it. Okay, guys, that's one thing that makes a life more difficult, and to focus on what actually matters, and that is real estate. Next part, guys. Open houses. Okay, let me list a house for you. How are you going to market it? I'm going to make a Facebook campaign, YouTube, post a video on YouTube, blah blah blah, and I'm going to host open houses. So guys, open houses, like an old school, everyone does it, people love doing open houses. Why do they do that though? Well, here's the reason, guys. Open houses are not meant to sell your house. I just told you the secret, guys. So who are the people that come to our house, open house? I'll give you 1 second to respond. It's your neighbors! So your neighbors want to come, see how you live, find out what's it listed for, compare your stuff to their stuff, and then to figure out if they're rich enough, did their property go up in price. So your neighbors and other people want to see your house to compare mainly their own property. It's very rare where somebody actually comes to an open house that wants to buy a house. Because if somebody, a serious buyer that wants to buy your place, they're going to get a realtor, they're going to book an appointment, they are going to come and they are going to buy your place. If they are serious, those people are seriously interested. Everybody else in the open house, most of them are not as serious. Only a few occasions where you would get a serious buyer who comes to an open house, and then your real estate agent still should not be double-siding the deal. Of course, it's 2 times the commission for them, but it's not the correct way to do that. They have to get a different real estate agent. So why would your real estate agent try to sell something on an open house by recommending to get some other real estate agent? That's the question that you should be asking your realtor. But open houses are there to prospect more clients, to try to get people, to represent them, to find houses for them. So open house is there for real estate agent to get more prospects, to get more money, to get more clients, and not only try and sell your house. And it's not the best marketing strategy anyways. It's an old school style to get more clients. Now guys, next part about it, real estate commission, you can negotiate. Real estate agents don't want you to know that because they want to get paid more. But in reality, guys, you can negotiate the deal. Absolutely, you can negotiate with your real estate agent. There are certain things that more or less acceptable on the market. There is a certain criteria. What we have here in Calgary, most of the commissions are pretty similar, but they're all negotiable. You can go up. If you really want to, if you really love me so much, you can pay me more. But in reality, guys, you can also go down if you really hate me. Anyways, guys, I'm just joking in here. But the truth is, you can negotiate, and the real estate agents, sometimes they don't want to say it, even though they're obligated, guys. Now, there was a good video by CBC Marketplace about stuff that's happening in Ontario, and I can throw a lot of stones towards the Ontario because people there, they do a lot of weird things. In Alberta, we are better. We don't do this kind of nonsense. At least not all of us. Anyways, guys, there are more spoiled apples according to the CBC Marketplace video that I watched in Ontario than it is in Alberta, where they made the research where some real estate agents were taking away the clients and sending them to somebody else, which is, because there was not enough commission for them. Wow, crazy. Next part is, well, I actually made a list of things. Well, buying or selling your house is actually a quiet, easy process, guys. Real estate agents want to make it more complicated because we want to get paid. That's why they make it sound more complicated. But once I got the training, once I already helped a lot of people buy so many properties, guys, I can tell you, it's easy. It's not complicated. What is complicated? Here's what you should know. The complicated part of selling real estate agent is number one, knowing the market, supply, demand, the statistics, that information that's available to real estate agents but not available to everybody else. So that kind of data that we have gives us an advantage. Next part about is having access to the MLS, which normal people don't have. Real estate agents do have. So that's another advantage. And last part is technology. So if you're going to see a place with the realtor and everything, so it may easier, less hassle, less work for you. So please hire me to represent you. Okay, guys, I'm just joking with you. But really, guys, it's not a difficult process. What's complicated is to know how much you can get for your house, to know how to market the house, to have access to the MLS, and, well, to meet all the people that are going to be coming to your house if you're selling it, or try and schedule the appointment with another real estate agent when you're going there, where everything can be done way more smoothly, way faster by a real estate agent that you would hire, because we have access to technology, and that's why we pay so much of money to maintain our license, and that's why being a real estate agent can cost you like $10,000 or $15,000 a year here in Alberta, depending on who, which brokerage and stuff like that, and all the expenses that we have. It is expensive to have that, and that's what we are paying for. And if you don't want to pay for all of that and you want to do it yourself, then there will be a struggle. Next, guys, it's more complicated. But it's not difficult, but it's more complicated. But if you know what you're doing and you have a good lawyer, you can do it. Next part, guys, well, there will be always another house. There will be always another property. This is the real estate agents don't want you to do it because they say, buy it now, because you're going to lose the deal. Why they say that? Well, because, well, sometimes it's just time to buy it. Sometimes you just seen too many properties and you can make up your mind. But that's not the real reason. Guys, reality is you can always find another property. You can almost always find something that meets your criteria. Something similar to what you've seen. Or even better, something that you would find even better than what you just saw. So if you lost a property, don't be disappointed. Market is always alive. It's always rotating. The same house that you are buying right now in 10 years might be back on the market. Even a year or so, you know, it can be back. It's not going to be there forever, at least. You know, not all the properties are like that. You know, staying with the family for generations. All I'm trying to say is, guys, there will always be another deal that might match your criteria, but real estate agents sometimes would push you to buy it. First of all, why they do it? Because once you buy something, they can jump on another client and keep on working and make more money. If you keep on spending too much of time, the more time they take with you, the more less money they make. And that's why sometimes people would push you. But in reality, guys, let me tell you from my perspective, I don't like pushing people. The only thing you should know is that while searching, while taking your time, when there is a good deal, you have to be ready to jump on it and get it. So that's the only thing that I'm going to tell you, guys, that sometimes if you don't buy it, you would be waiting and wasting a lot of your time, your stress, your energy to find the same kind of property that is already there. So sometimes it's time to buy it. But Really, if you lost it, don't be disappointed. There will be another chance in real estate, guys. Another part that can go different is your financial condition. Your spouse or yourself might have a baby, you might lose a job, something bad might happen, and then you're not able to afford what you wanted right now because circumstances have changed. And now, in this kind of situation, you're not going to have a second chance unless you fix your financial situation. But in reality, you didn't get the property, your financial situation went down. It's actually good because you're not going to be housed. So guys, if you like this kind of video, if I just blasted a bunch of realtors, guys, myself, Igor Realtsev, is EXP Realty here in Calgary. Give me a call, my contact's in the description of this video. I hope you like this kind of video. I just wanted to tell you a lot of information, guys. And if you want to more details, guys, now if you want to hire me, I'm willing to help you and answer all the questions. And if you're in other provinces in Canada, I can refer you to good agents over there, guys. Myself is EXP Realty. We have a lot of people all over Canada. So give me a shout, guys, and I'll connect you to the right person. And smash the like button, subscribe to this channel. We'll see you in the next video, guys. Bye for now. Happy house hunting.